Ovechkin leading Washington into UBS Arena, New York's new address on the island. Looks spiffy. Today's marquee matchup is brought to you by Sandy Spring Bank. They believe real banking is a conversation. Let's talk. For starters, we can yak about the Capitals doing their work in the daytime, facing an Islanders club that's finally adjusted to their new home. A very pleasant welcome to you. I'm back in this guy's playhouse, along with Craig Lachlan. I'm Joe Beninati. The NHL has All-Star festivities planned for February in Las Vegas, and this Thompson Creek window of opportunity is just a demo tape for why Alex Ovechkin belongs there.
And the fans have spoken in a big way. A ton of votes for the Capitals captain. He's having an MVP-type season, 12th All-Star selection, fifth time as a captain, 24 goals, only Draisaitl more, 17 even, six power plays, and a shorty. He leads in even strength points. He leads Caps forwards in plus-minus. He is playing as complete a game as we have seen Alex in his career, including that marker there, which leads him now in PPGs ahead of Dave Andrechuk.
Folks, after dropping their first seven inside the new digs, the Isles are liking the look of UBS Arena. Blue and orange fans, they appreciate the amenities and the improved play next. Saving you money on car insurance has been in Geico's playbook for 85 years. Visit geico.com today to see all the ways you can save. By Sandy Spring Bank, we believe real banking is a conversation. Let's talk. Visit sandyspringbank.com/real. And by McDonald's. Get a free six-piece McNuggets with minimum dollar purchase tomorrow on the McDonald's app if the Caps score in the McNugget Minute. Nothing like a division rivalry to get the blood boiling in the NHL. Metro Division neighbors New York and Washington have at it today. Plenty of crash and bang. Put up your dukes and spit out a few harsh words. Matinee in Elmont, New York, UBS Arena at Belmont Park. First time ever hosting Alex Ovechkin and the Washington Capitals. Great to see the Capitol captain out there. He missed a few days of practice this week, getting set for what will be a very busy weekend. Very good to see number 74, John Carlson, on the ice, who joined the boys very, very late for warm-up after testing negative for COVID and being active in today's lineup. The on-ice officials and referees are Chris Lee and Furman South. Scott Cherry and Libor Suchanek have the lines. New York on home ice, and they'll be here a lot lately in the blue.
Yeah, they couldn't find a win the first five or seven games, but now they are on a roll at home. The Caps are going to have to play a very stellar defensive game here today.
Capitals coming in third place in the Metro Division, trailing the Rangers and the Hurricanes. Carolina in action right about now. Top of the screen, you're seeing Peter Laviolette's line combinations and D pairings. The Islanders currently eighth in the Metro Division. They play the fewest amount of games of any squad in the NHL. Back through center, John Carlson on his horse, using the boards to get it back on to center, where Oshie trundles it into the New York zone. Varlamov tees it up, waits for help. Mayfield triggers the breakout. Wahlstrom through center. Wahlstrom, who scored his first ever NHL goal in D.C., lost the handle there.
He's playing very well right now for the Islanders. Brings him up, but a little more pop offensively. When Wahlstrom's at his best, he's shooting the puck a ton. Vitek has to be prepared.
Ovechkin, his pass taken by Dowd on the rotation. Long wrister that was blocked in front by Zach Parise. Irwin taking the boards away. Islanders get the jump. This is an odd man rush potential. Barzell on the feed. Vanacek gets over to make the save on Parise.
Yeah, real good back check by the Capitals captain. Make sure he did not give up on the skating. He skated toe-to-toe with Parise, trying to jam that one home short side.
Moving ahead for New York, Bailey on the drop to Barzell. Playmaking center sends it out wide. Seam pass intended for Bailey, clicked off of his boots.
And beware of Barzell, points in nine straight for him, nine straight that he's played in, so he's a catalyst. He puts up big points and always has, especially against the Caps.
Lars Eller sent one softly to Semyon Varlamov, a former Washington Capital who is between the pipes for New York today. Jensen there to play against Anders Lee. Sprong on it. Leaves for McMichael. The return pass that was blocked. Islanders with some get up and go. 3-on-3 through center. Curling drag move from Brock Nelson, not fooling the Washington defense. Carlson was at the ready, and Eller skies this back into the New York zone.
Just enough of John Carlson's skates to stay in the proper lane to prevent Brock Nelson, who likes to try to beat you man on man.
Approaching the 3-minute mark, nothing-nothing first period up in New York today. Capitals get home to square off with the Vancouver Canucks tomorrow afternoon. Snapshot on the way from Sprong, who has wonderful numbers against the Islanders in his career. In fact, his best against any opponent.
And he's got some beauties of goals. He's got to continue to shoot that puck. Varlamov upstairs might be where to go today against him.
Isles in the blue, tossing this one back to center. Alexei Protas there for Washington. Connor Sherry now in COVID-19 protocol, missing today's tilt along with Dmitry Orlov and Carl Hagelin. As Varlamov latches on, he'll squeeze. Folks, the Discover matchup, it pulls back the curtain on today's netminders.
Yeah, it's going to be Vitek Vanacek, 6-4-5 on the season against the Islanders. He's 3-1 versus Semyon Varlamov, 2-5-1. He's picked up his last two wins in his last two games. He stopped 76 of the last 78. He couldn't buy a win when he went 0-5-1 to start the season.
First appearance of the new year for number 40 in blue. Tangling against his old mates. Varlamov now 33 years of age. Right off the draw, quick chance there that rattles off the outside of the goal. Mayfield with room, able to play it on out. J.G. Pageau, new daddy in the lineup for New York.
Yeah, two of them new daddies on the same day. Sebastian Aho, a defenseman, also had a baby.
Back to point position. Long range from Pelech, the Islander All-Star representative. Pageau twisting it down low. As we near the 4-minute mark, nothing, nothing at UBS Arena.
Pelech has had a great season, really solidifying their D, especially with Pollock, his normal partner, out of the lineup. He's been a go-to guy for Trotz when he's behind the bench.
Pollock on COVID-19 protocol, missing today.
As is Barry Trotz, the bench boss we normally see. Lane Lambert takes over the head coaching duties.
Mayfield working back through center, a pass that's off target. Comes all the way down, no icing here. Jensen for Washington, right up the gut for Backstrom. Tom Wilson angling into the zone. Met there by Salo. Wilson, plenty of room, he scores! Tom Wilson!
That's a dart, exactly what the Capitals needed from Tom and the boys to start this hockey game. Tom Wilson has been running cold for the Caps. He's been struggling finding the twine, but there he connects on a beautiful, beautiful shot. You couldn't script this any better on the way he shoots the puck. He controls, sets, and fires and beats Varlamov stick side. Protas will get the primary helper. The Caps are up 1-0 against the Islanders.
Tom Wilson gets himself into double figures in terms of goals this season. Rugged winger, now 9 seasons as a pro, scored his first ever goal against the New York Islanders. And his locker was detailing, he's been cool lately. For Tom, just his second goal in the last dozen games. But it gives Washington the advantage. This Capitals squad that's customarily out in front with the game's first marker has done it again. Jensen winds and fires. He sailed that one against Varlamov on the blocker side.
And that's a real nice looking shot from Tom. That should give him some confidence when it comes to scoring goals against Lane Lambert, his former assistant coach. Spent a lot of time in Washington under the tutelage of Barry Trotz, and now here in town.
Lane, like you, getting fancy with the printed dress shirt.
I'm gonna start doing that more often. I like his today.
Glad you, and what about Mr. Laviolette?
Absolutely. Always dapper.
Can't tell about the neckwear yet from profile?
I'm waiting for tomorrow afternoon for neckwear.
I see. Oh, that's the best. That's the best when Mr. Boudreaux enters the arena.
And I know he's not watching because he has a game, so he's not going
right
to hear
now.
It. Yeah.
Last check, Carolina leading Vancouver on a goal by Trocheck, 2-1 down in Raleigh.
And Halak under protocol today. And we expected to see him tomorrow.
Isles on the rush here. Nelson deflecting. Vanacek made a pad stop. 5-on-5 play continues just past the 5-minute mark of this first frame. First of four meetings between these two, McMichael comes cross rink. Snapshot on the way that was blunted by the defense of Robin Salo, 23-year-old Finnish blue liner. Farivari there for Washington, using the boards to get it ahead to the turning Daniel Sprong. Tape to tape for Brett Leeson, angled by Pelech. Pelech, such a good stick, always in good position.
Yeah, well-schooled, obviously, and I think because of his stick, he's always put up against the top lines in the National Hockey League. Impressive, and named to the All-Star team for the first time. A lot of first-timers going to Vegas in the National Hockey League for the All-Star festivities.
Pageau pinched against the backboards. Worked on around. Dowd's exit pass was thieved. Wahlstrom lost his balance right into the waiting arms of Justin Schultz. Alexei Protas, the lone assist on that Wilson strike, giving Washington the lead as Vanacek makes the save on the long drive from Chara, and he'll hold. TV timeout for us on NBC Sports Washington. Thinking back, Wilson gets Washington off to a fine start on Long Island.
There's so much new to...
Thanks to Tom Wilton at 4:35. Locker with this Taco Bell tape. We offer the Cliff Notes on the aisles up until now.
Yeah, they played their first 13 games of the season on the road. They went 5-6-2, not too bad. 18 players and head coach Barry Trotz have been placed on the COVID list. 9 games postponed. 85 man games lost to injury or COVID. And because of the start of the season with so many games on the road, they're in a stretch here of 10 of 11 on their new turf.
Capitals with the opening marker lock in 9 of their last 11 games. This team in white trying to snap out of a 4-game losing skid or winless skid today with a 1-0 advantage over the Isles.
And it's all going to come down to defense in those 4 losses. They were outscored 18-9. They've got to tighten up defensively against this Islander club today.
Stepping out wide, Daniel Sprong fought off there. Matt Martin taps it on around. There's the veteran blue liner Andy Green looking to clear with Cizikas through center. This Islander bunch, the lowest scoring team in the National Hockey League entering play today.
Yeah, the Caps about 1 goal better, and they're under 2.5. But recently, since they've come home, got their game back together, got most of their guys into the lineup, they've been much better for whoever's behind the bench scoring goals.
Before it's all said and done, there will be 13 games played today and tonight around the NHL. Originally, it was 16. Everybody in the pool today in the entire league, but 3 of those games have been postponed. As Kuznetsov wanders through center, looks for Alex Ovechkin, forced back away at the Islander line.
That was a nice play by Mayfield. Talk about taking away time and space. The big rig knows he can't give Ovi the blue line, uses his reach and his strength to make that play.
Locked up at center. Protas sends it on for Wilson. Back for Alexei. That was healed and blocked by Zdeno Chara.
That was a good quick up by the Caps. They caught the Islanders and Chara in a line change among their D and just about cost them making that seam pass.
Those who follow the Isles closely say that Chara's getting more and more comfortable, looks better and better as the season progresses. Beauvillier's bid is blocked by Carlson and out of play. From the promo department, Caps fans, Xfinity Mobile delivering fast nationwide 5G on the most reliable network. Save on your wireless bill with Xfinity Mobile. Caps, 20 victories this season. 10 on the road, 10 at home. Working against Kiefer Bellows and the New York Islanders today inside of UBS Arena.
They are hoping for another shutout. Their 14th straight. 17,255 for the newest building in the National Hockey League.
Make sure I keep you away from the betting windows. The track is so close by. You could see Locker running over there to put down a wager or two. Chara loops us to the back end boards where Schultz is there. Off the rotation. Not a lot of room for Bellows to operate along with Nelson and Beauvillier. This one's golfed around. Caps in their white sweaters. Long send out for McMichael. One-on-one, he fires. That's off the glove of Varlamov.
He's very good at getting pucks to the net, is McMichael. One of the best among the rookie class, especially for the Caps. He doesn't shoot the puck wide a whole lot. Makes contact there on the goaltender, and that's a good save by Farley as that puck by McMichael trying to go top corner.
Happy birthday, Connor. 21 today. I remember those days. Eons ago.
Don't we all?
1-0 for the Caps. If you're just tuning in, we shout out hello to everybody rocking the rink at the Wharf today. Nice day for the outdoor festivities.
Chilly, you need to
bundle up.
Oh, man, you need the fire pit and everything going there.
I thought you were going with the fire water.
Yeah, that's a good combination.
Almost 9 minutes clear in this opening period. Wilson's 10th from Protas, giving Washington the advantage. Salo sprints back through center. He'll send it on around. That's Vitek Vanacek in goal today. Ilya Samsonov sitting second chair to him as Eller scoops it to center. Ilya Sorokin is the backup to Varlamov for New York.
Man, he's been playing well, hasn't he?
He's their number one.
Yeah.
Barzal drops it off as the Isles load up for a breakout. We close up on Robin Salo, called up from the American Hockey League in November, came in from Bridgeport, Connecticut. This is all the way down icing against the Isles.
Got some good defensive posture. That's why that Salo pass did not connect against Daniel Sprong and his mates here in the first period, just about halfway through.
Talked about Sprong and his success against New York in his career. 7 goals in 11 games. That's Ovechkin-like.
That sure is.
Matt Martin, annually among the NHL's hit leaders, gets back into the lineup after Ross Johnsonen was hit with a 3-game suspension. Matt Martin was held out of the lineup when the Isles took care of the Devils back on Thursday.
The so-called identity line struggling a little bit with Cizikas, Clutterbuck, and Martin. When you look at their plus-minus, you say, what? Minus 15 combined. They're usually money, at least even or better when they played as a trio.
Protas marching through center more than halfway through this opening period. Noah Dobson works through center. Dobson will dump it in. Vanacek slows it down. Ferravari connecting with Protas. And he'll clear in. Dowd over skates there. Isles will make a break for it with Dobson on the head man for Pageau. At the attacking line, this is deflected wide of the goal. Jumping on the loose biscuit, Nick Dowd for Washington. Then Brett Leason on that cross-corner dump-in. Pellick's the first back on it. Leason makes the swipe. Starts the cycle for the Capitals. 5-on-5 play here in this opening period. Neither team has had a power play. Carlson long wrister, patted down by Varlamov. Back through center. Good poke check from Dowd on Wahlstrom, his opposite number 26.
We have not seen TJ Oshie, Joe, so they're playing with 11 forwards, it looks like now.
Dowd fires off the shoulder of Varlamov, who got cleaned out from that crease.
Especially his right side. He was contorted in a weird way. What a save that was on a Hathaway high tip out of midair. He didn't even have a stick in his hands after getting run over earlier on in the shift.
Hathaway looked like he was playing high lie or lacrosse there. That was wild. Varlamov made the save. Kuznetsov on the move, strolling in. Crisscrossing with Ovechkin, and Ovechkin knocked down his center.
Yeah, hit his skates. Skates on skates there as he tried a lateral move against Alex.
Jensen sends it away down the flank. It's out of the reach of its intended target.
And he's going slow to the benches, Kuznetsov, bent over.
Working in, Isles hook off, look for the late guy, Dobson rolling in, off the post, rebound there. Beauvillier had a chance, he did not fire in time. As the Caps go the other way, Sprong leading the thrust. Sprong turning and burning, he drew a penalty. A call now, it appears, against New York. With 7:51 to go in the opening frame, and the Caps on top by one, should be a power play on the other side.
The DQ Chicken Strip Basket and Rotisserie Stuff.
Sunday shows you the last run-in with number 8.
Yeah, it goes laterally, and then Ovi's coming off the wall thinking he was going to get the puck earlier, and there's the right leg on the right leg. Alex Ovechkin on Kuznetsov, and he went down in a heap. He was slow going to the bench with Sprong drawing a penalty. good news for Caps fans, he's right back out on the ice.
At Hyundai, the longer you look, the more there is to like. Visit your local Hyundai dealer today.
And the bumper guy will be Tom Wilson. The goal scorer, it's usually TJ Oshie. He's played two shifts, a buck 46, and went down the runway to the locker room, and we have not seen him since.
Capitals trying to find the magic potion for their power play. You see the numbers at the bottom of the screen. Snapshot pad saved by Varlamov. As the rebound's bunted to the corner and cleared, this Washington team with just three power play goals in the last 15 games.
Yeah, 3 for 41. Who would have thought that with the power that the Capitals possess with the extra man? Unbelievable low number.
Nicholas Backstrom gaining ground through center. Out wide for Wilson. That was swiped and cleared in one fell swoop. 80 seconds left on the power play as John Carlson works ahead. Carlson leads the Caps with 4 goals in the first periods this season. 3 of those on the power play. Kuznetsov spins it on around. Along the boards, jamming for it, Parisi. As Ovechkin slides in and fires, just missed it on the short side. Backstrom gets a topside for Carlson, and around the horn it comes to the captain. Carlson straight away. Backstrom looking to the interior. Kuznetsov posted up inside with Wilson. Backstrom's got a pretty good shooting angle there. Didn't elect to take it. Plays patty cake with Carlson. Now fires, pad save Varlamov. Rebound to Carlson, once more for Backstrom. Kuznetsov with his eyes up. 33 seconds on the power play. Kuznetsov, two-man game. Fires, just missed it there as Varlamov was hugging that goalpost. Chara nudged it around the corner and out.
You can see the one guy they're taking away is the bumper guy, whether it be Wilson or Oshie, when he's usually in that spot. Chara was all over him, which allows that low guy to create a two-on-one.
One-timer Carlson hit traffic in front. Final 7 seconds on the power play. Kuznetsov look-away pass for Backstrom. Back door looking for Ovechkin. That was deflected as the Isles survive on the PK. Washington had a lot of threats there. They moved the puck pretty well compared to what's been going on of late with a man advantage.
Yeah, very good zone time and good setup. They executed the plays they were looking to, going against that penalty kill unit that had allowed a power play goal 3 of the last 4. They had them running a little bit, and that's a good sign for their first extra man look for the Caps today.
So we're back to 5-on-5 play. 5:20 left in this opening period. Tom Wilson's giving the Caps the lead. Nick Dowd fires, had it blocked there by Dobson, and it's out of play. We'll get you away from UBS Arena for a moment, get you back for the conclusion of the opening period right after these words.
Buffalo Wild Wings
winners fan in attendance today. The Caps have a 1-0 advantage.
I'm watching Cobra Kai as we speak. I love it.
Of course you are. In the VW game notes, we see some slippage from the Caps.
First 20 games, all their D were intact. All 6 of them played together. Goals allowed per game are up. Penalty kill down. Shots against per game are up a couple. Save percentage way down. That's an area, to me, will tell the tale of the tape today. Is Vitek's goaltending will secure a win if it's 9:15 or better here today against the Islander Bunch.
Far be it for me to ask you to pay attention today. I understand. You've got your eyes elsewhere, other projects that you're working on. Vanacek going to cover this one up with 4:57 to go in the first.
Well, if he has a 9:38 like he does in his career against his Islander club and Wahlstrom, he'll be in good shape, will Vitek. Wahlstrom, Bellows, guys like that, they've got younger, they've got faster, they've really cooked them well down in the minor leagues, and that's the key when you're with a Lou Lamoriello-run team. They utilize the minors to their advantage to make sure players are ready once they step into the NHL stage.
21-year-old Wahlstrom shooting against Vitek Vanacek, who turned 26 last weekend. Caps have been off since their loss to Boston. Vanacek made a dozen stops in relief of Zach Fucale in that loss to the Bees.
And that's his first game in mop-up style in his last 6 overall. 32:03 time on ice for Vitek against the Bees.
Hathaway and Dowd rummaging in the corner along with Leeson. Salo pouncing on that for New York. Again, we have not seen much of T.J. Oshie after a couple of shifts today. Quick centering pass, Varlamov to stop in the cover.
That's a fabulous stop on Garnet Hathaway. I can't believe it. It should be 2-0. Timely saves are critical. We were talking about the Caps goaltending in the pregame show, and here you see a timely save, or it's 2-0. Nice rotation down low. Dow's going to find Hathaway and a quick spinorama right there. Nice low and hard. Did he ever nicely, firmly put down that left pad to keep that puck out of the net?
Varlamov, all eyes on this draw. A long point drive that's deflected over top of the crossbar. Eller twisting to a backhand. Stopped by Varlamov.
That might have even been better than the Hathaway save he made moments ago. That was a spinorama through traffic that he's able to gobble up on the butterfly.
Carlson reversing it to Ferravari. Washington rookie blue liner scoots through center. Kuznetsov on the toe drag move. Sweeps that pass to the slot area. Ovechkin was well guarded. Kiefer Bellows launching it ahead on the slap shot here that sizzled high by Beauvillier. Nelson juggling the puck away from Carlson. Help comes from Lars Eller. His support not able to get it clear. Bellows fires, trying to catch Vanacek napping. Noah Dobson works it for Beauvillier. Out wide, Chara bombs away. That's deflected.
Noah Dobson's had the best chance against the Caps here in the first. He rang the post on a beautiful move on a curl and drag, walking right up the gut. All five of his goals have come right here at USB Arena.
Washington out shooting New York by a 4-1 ratio. As Protas lobs it in, a hit Chara up high. 3:15 away from Integrate Intermission Live, are we? Working from our NBC Sports Washington studios today, Joe Beninati, Craig Lachlan. Turning things over to Alexa Landeskog and Alan May in a few moments.
And T.J. Oshie will not return, says Capitals PR, due to upper body injury.
Boy, oh boy, it has been some kind of season for 77.
Can't get any traction whatsoever in and out of the lineup. Injuries, COVID, you name it. Here's that little play down low. Good opportunity for the Caps to break out, but here's Beauvillier's chance. Nice sauce up the ice. Beautiful pass by Bellows, and there's Beauvillier taking a wicked blast. Chara against Protas gets hit high on the dump in by Protas. No worse for wear.
Tom Wilson has it for DC. Through the wickets of Protas. Long slapper from Matt Irwin that's deflected wide of the cage. Cizikas tabling this one for Green, and the Isles are out of there swiftly. Clutterbuck on for Martin. Martin will dump it in. Irwin checking over the shoulder. Backstrom there for Washington. He ladled it, but not out. Matt Martin keeps it down low. Clutterbuck occupied by Schultz. Barzell swooping into the picture. Chara a long way from the goal. Returns it to Barzell. Chara one-timer, flagged down and held by Vanacek.
No problem on that long-range blast from Chara. Looking for his first goal of the season, playing his 1,635th game here tonight among blue liners. That's tied for second most now. Only Chelios is ahead of that big warrior. And Barzell is the guy that provides them Ojo. Since he arrived on the scene on the Islanders roster, no one has more points than Barzell. He's a key guy to keep an eye on today.
You've alluded to how hot he's been in his last 9 games with points in each of those. Van Riemsdyk and Jensen to the rescue for Washington, breaking a break for it at the line offside against the Capitals.
Yeah, it's that little hitch at the end of that play by Jensen, who I've loved his game. I loved him with Chara. I think that developed him very well when Chara was a Washington Capital. He started out as an Islander, played 231 games, and made most of his mark in the NHL with the Boston Bruins. And now back on the island on a 1-year deal.
Big Z.
Mm-hmm. Back in the day, that was a big trade. Remember, that was the Yashin deal with the Ottawa Senators.
7 foot tall for one guy, and a very promising turtleneck on the other.
I love the turtle one.
Chara lets this one go. Nelson looking for the rebound. Van Riemsdyk had it for Washington. Didn't get it out.
I think it's better to be the great one than the turtled one.
Sweep wraparound attempt from Bellows. Denied. Vanacek without his goalie stick. Islanders still in business. Beauvillier fires. Pad save. And Vanacek without that stick able to dive out and cover. as we get some tough stuff in front.
Yeah, he was clipped in the head at the top of the helmet there in that little push at the end of that play. That's why the Capitals took exception to that. Vitek lost his stick behind the net, still able to make a nice play in front of the net. Here's the Islanders keeping pucks alive, and that's a key for the Caps, the danger zone. Get it out over the blue line. You can't turn it over there. Bellows, like his dad, very good hands around the net. He, too, is running hot. 8 points his last eight games. He got a couple of good shots in his last shift there. Thank goodness for Vitek stop and play there.
Our friends at Sport Radar reminding us the last four games, the Caps save percentage numbers below 86. A comment that was made as well by our stats man extraordinaire, Carter Myers. The Caps need the netminders to make those stops on shots that they're supposed to get. A few of them that they're not. Just looking for consistency more than anything from Messrs. Samsonov and today Vanacek.
Yeah, and he's hoping that one of them is Laviolette, steps forward and has that consistency because he'll get the majority of the games.
For Washington, game number 38 today, 20 victories, 8 regulation losses, 9 losses that have come after 60 minutes. We are in the McNugget minute of the opening period. Pageau on the goal, fanned on a snapshot as he was defended by Carlson. Point position Mayfield, looking for the high tip play. Should the Caps score in this final minute of the period? It would be a free 6-piece McNugget with a minimum $1 purchase. Available only on the McDonald's app the next day.
It's nice getting the jump on the Islanders. They don't score a whole bunch because of that. Trailing after one, the Islanders have one win in 11 tries at 1-8-2.
Tom Wilson, before this game, was 5 minutes old from Alexei Protas, as we hear a whistle with just over 19 ticks remaining.
Not a bad road period against the Islanders, who are heating up here on home ice. And take a look there, their all-star Pellick going up against Leason back in the lineup for the Caps. It's been a jumbled bunch of forwards here in the first with TJ Oshie only playing two shifts, so they've had to utilize just 11 forwards against the Islanders here today.
Protas with a helper, whispering in the ears of Matt Martin his two goals this season against Carolina and Columbus. Face-off at neutral ice. Cizikas getting the better of Kuznetsov. 14 seconds to go. On the boards, Ovechkin lifting it back to center. Pellick there in a foot race with Schultz. 3 ticks left as the siren sounds inside UBS Arena with Washington on top by 1.
I have to say it was a quiet period, which is a good sign for the goal scorer, Tom Wilson. Quiet play means you're probably playing well defensively. Exactly what the doctor ordered to get off the snide for the guys in white today.
Capitals learning this morning, early this afternoon, they would be without Connor Sherry and now without TJ Oshie. So they'll be playing one forward short for the balance of this contest. 1-0 Washington. Wilson from Protas as we get you set for Integrate Intermission Live. Yes, Mr. Macchio, the Isles are down by 1. Hello, John Carlson. Get out there and get to work. Alexa Landestoy, Alan May, from one studio to the next for Integrate Intermission Live.
Integrate Intermission Live.
Capitals with the 4-day layoff, but looking strong to begin this period. That's Alan May. I'm Alexa Landestoy. This is Capitals Integrate Intermission Live. And the guy that gave the Capitals a 1-0 lead in the first period, Tom Wilson, he is standing by now. And Tom, I got to get your take. You lost Connor Sherry just before game time. You get John Carlson back. What is it like from a player's perspective dealing with all these different shakeups to your guys' lineup?
Yeah, it almost seems like the norm now a little bit. You're coming into game day, you never know what's going to happen. So you just got to stay focused and, you know, every guy is an individual. Just get ready for the game. And, you know, if a guy makes it back out of protocol or whatever, you just go with the flow. And we were happy to see Johnny come back out there.
And, Tom, on your goal, an excellent pass by Alexei Protas. And you were so wide open on that play. I assume the only thought you had was you had to shoot that puck on Varlamov.
Yeah, like I was kind of thinking, like, how long do I have? Because I couldn't see behind me, obviously. So I wanted to make sure I got it off because you don't have that much time and space that often in this league. So I was lucky to get it to go there.
Tom, thank you so much for joining us.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
And now it's time now for us to take a look at Tom Wilson's 10th goal of the season in our Geico highlight. So great that the Washington Capitals got on the board right away. And I think we're going to dance around. I don't think we have the video just quite yet. But what a game from the Capitals to begin this And here we go now. We got the video.
Yeah, and you know, the big thing here, Nick Backstrom getting the puck down the ice. You want to skate the puck in the zone. Alexi Protas posts up, keep from going offside, and then a great, beautiful backhand pass to Wilson. And this is a bad goal by the standards of Mitch Korn. This goes through the goaltender. It goes between the elbow and the pad, and definitely a goal that they're not going to be happy with. A little while later, though, the Islanders come down the ice. Noah Dobson, an excellent young offensive player, rings that one off the post, but the Caps do a good job of finding the rebound and keeping the Islanders from getting a second chance. You see how they were all blocking out. Great defensive work after that initial play of some blown coverage.
Yeah, and already without Connor Sherry, then they lose TJ Oshie just two shifts into this game and a little bit over 3.5 minutes into this period. We didn't see him the rest of the game, and we now know he is out with an upper body injury, a tough blow for the Capitals.
Yeah,
to start.
Well, it's just like every team in the National Hockey League, and the Capitals are not strangers to this. Every single night, every single game or afternoon, there's a roster shuffle, so you have to be able to mix and match and play with everyone, and the coaching staff has to be able to manipulate the ice time. And a lot of times, the players want to play more. Every single player wants to get more ice time, so this is an excellent opportunity for other players. And TJ just can't seem to stay in the lineup right now. It's another tough blow to him. Seems like he gets in, then he's out. It's been a tough season so far for him.
Tough. We need that consistency. We want these guys back healthy. And as Tom Wilson said, great get John Carlson back. That video trending on social media, that big smile on his face as he joined his team today on the island. And still to come, we're going to take a closer look at the Capitals' chances during that first period on the power play. What do we think of that opportunity? We'll get that next. By the numbers and our Acura game stats, the Washington Capitals came out with a great start, 16-7 shots on goal in favor of the Caps. And then you see there are 6 block shots for the Islanders and then 1 power play opportunity in the first there, Alan.
Yeah, the big thing, winning in the faceoffs, doubling up in the shots and shot attempts, doing an excellent job right now. And some different looks on the power play where they had 3 shots.
We like those numbers, that I got to keep this up for the next 40. And let's dive into our Thompson Creek window of opportunity and take a closer look at the Capitals' PP to start the first.
Yeah, and you can see that the Islanders are playing very conservative, and Ovi going to the back post trying to bring their forward down. They bring Cal Cutterbuck down there, and they keep an eye. So the Caps are going to find some areas there where they can take advantage of the Islanders as this game goes on. You can see a different setup. They're standing still, so if the Capitals start to move their legs and move the puck around, they should have some better chances. A lot of times, teams don't respect the shot of Nicklas Backstrom, and they let him have it. And you want to start seeing he and Evgeny Kuznetsov start to skate in on those shots when they have the open lane with a lot more speed and test the goaltender and maybe force them out of position there with a great backdoor look to Alexander Ovechkin, who just fans on that one.
Yeah, I'd love to see Backstrom back on that power play. The Washington Capitals looking to load on those goals. They come into today's game 29th overall on the power play. Well, we're looking ahead to the second period when we come back.
It's time to go Toyota with legendary safety and reliability. Toyota, let's go places. By MGM National Harbor, celebrating 5 monumental years in the community. By Comcast Business, powering possibilities. And by McDonald's, get a free 6-piece McNuggets with minimum dollar purchase tomorrow on the McDonald's app if the Caps score in the McNugget minute.
Welcome back. It's time now for us to peek at live lines powered by PointsBet. PointsBet offers more live betting, more bet types, more cash outs, and more ways to live your bet life. So download that PointsBet app now, use code Washington, and get your first bets risk-free up to $2,000 and get in on the action for the rest of the game. The Capitals began this game at 52%. Now they're at 69%. So clearly the Capitals getting off to that hot start is going to help them today.
Certainly. You know what? The shooting from everywhere, making sure they got net front presence. But the biggest thing, managing the puck the rest of the way. The Islanders are sitting, lying in wait, trying to create offense off of turnovers. The few times that the Capitals did give up some soft pucks, the Islanders went right after them. So the big thing this period, be smart with the puck, continue to shoot, and win all your battles.
Yeah, huge shout out to all the Caps fans out at the Wharf today, the Rock, the Rink. They are watching this game today. Hopefully the Capitals can keep things rolling and get the win. We'll get you back to Joe Beninati and Craig Laughlin for second period action just after this.
Written permission of the National Hockey League is prohibited. Our NBC Sports Washington coverage of Capitals hockey is being brought to you by your local Washington area Honda dealers. when you want to get more, then it has to be a Honda. Don't settle for less. Visit your local Honda dealer today. By MedStar Health, easy access to great health care. It's how we treat people. By Iron Bow, visit them at ironbow.com. And by IT Cadre, innovation, transformation. IT Cadre, your vision, our purpose. Today, the Capitals taking their first steps inside UBS Arena and locker. We may have isolated what happened to TJ Oshie early.
Check out the front of the net. He reaches up with his right arm and then winces and heads off in slow motion. One more look. There's the right arm as he tries to pick that puck out of midair. Flowing through the net was Alex Ovechkin flipping it high. Raises his arm. An upper body injury. It's been a stop and start season for TJ. Started the season all right, missed 10, missed 6, then missed 3, and came back against the Boston Bruins.
Oshie played only 2 shifts today, a total of 1 minute and 46 seconds. Shortly thereafter, it was Tom Wilson on the board at 4:35 with his 10th of the season from Alexei Protas. And that's where we are right now as the second period gets rolling. 1-0 for the guys in the white sweaters. First of 4 meetings between themselves and the New York Islanders. The initial game between these two was postponed as the league decided to extend the holiday break around Christmas time. Former Caps Zdeno Chara heads back for Noah Dobson. The Isles, who have been getting points routinely now at home after struggling inside of their new rink, with Lane Lambert taking over for Barry Trotz today as Coach Trotz is still on the COVID-19 protocol list.
The Islanders started 0-5-2 at USB. Now they're on a 5-0-1 tear in their last 6, and they've got a lot of home cooking. If they're going to get into the playoffs, this home streak of 10 of the next 11 is a must for them, because then they have, in April, another 8-game road trip lurking ahead.
We mentioned the Islanders and the Senators are the two teams that have played the fewest number of games as the Caps work the cycle here for Ovechkin on the rotation play, trying to hook up with Ferravari. Both of these teams, the Caps and Isles, be very busy. The Washington Capitals playing 8 games in 14 days, 11 in 20 days for New York.
New York has 8 games in hand on the Washington Capitals, if you can believe it.
Off this turnover, happy 21st birthday to Connor McMichael, Washington rookie. Expects to see a bit more ice time now with TJ Oshie not returning. McMichael driving in, fires Varlamov with a blocker pad save.
Poor defense by the Islanders. I'm surprised they allowed him to walk in without anybody touching him or going to him. That's a good stop by Varlamov with the right side of his body and blocker.
Capitals have had the only power play on the day. A New York team a season ago that was the least penalized per game. Leeson carving in, fires! He yanked that one wide. This season, the Islanders are taking way more penalties per game, ranked 21st. Dowd funnels into the corner. Send it on around, point position, the snapshot that's broken up in front. They continue to battle for it. Schultz on a slap pass. Leeson too hot to handle. Irwin gets involved. Hathaway is forced back to center by Wahlstrom, and there's Schultz to help. Justin leaves it on the woodwork for the turning Dowd. Shots on goal story, top of the screen. At one point, the Caps were out shooting the Isles 16-4.
Ended up 16-7. A good job in the first period. They got to continue with all those rubbers, all those pucks going towards Varlamov. He's got to be under duress a little bit here today.
Vitek Vanacek guarding the goal for the Capitals as Hathaway strides through center, and he'll dump it in. Peter Laviolette asking for the line change. Pelech back behind Varlamov. He normally works with Pulock, but Ryan finds himself on the COVID-19 protocol list. Capitals missing Anthony Mantha on injury. 28 games now. Hard shooting left winger has been missing after the shoulder surgery. On the protocol list for Washington, Orlov Haglund joined today by Connor Sherry. There was some worry that John Carlson was headed to that list, but he was deemed eligible as Lee fires. It's plucked out of the air by Vitek Vanacek. Locker on the Toyota Star Track. These blue liners have definitely logged a lot of time.
And Chris Chelios at the top of the list. Zdeno Chara and Scotty Stevens tied at 16:35. Among all-time games played, Chelios 8th, Chara 10th, Stevens 11th, 17 to pass Chelios. He will end up being the defenseman in NHL history to play the most games.
Chara, 3 times a Slovakian Olympian, 25 seasons as a pro. Ferravari turns. Ferravari, who had that additional year in the American Hockey League while the Caps worked with Zdeno Chara in Caps colors. Ferravari muscling up back behind the goal with Clutterbuck. Another guy who's annually among the league leaders in hits.
Well, that's sort of a identity. They call him that for the purpose of that, because Clutterbuck and Martin in particular, they unload on guys, and that's why they've got that heavy looking forecheck. It's because they go 2-1-2. Those two guys, Martin and Clutterbuck in particular, are the guys that stir the puck.
This is Martin through center. Matt will clear it in. As we've just crossed the 4-minute mark of the second, Backstrom tapping one for Matt Irwin. He'll launch it through neutral. Sprong going after Pellick. Pellick will use the net for some cover for J.G. Pageau. Kuznetsov covering up through center. Weeks the takeaway and sends in.
Rotating right wingers, it looks like, for the Caps with TJ out. You have Sprong now playing on that top line with Ovi and Kuznetsov.
Parisi finds Pageau, then Pellick right up the gut. Pellick stick checked by Van Riemsdyk. Parisi collared by Van Riemsdyk. 5-on-5 at the offensive end for New York. Green lets it fly, knocked down in front. Kuznetsov cleans it up. And there is a whistle and a penalty called away from the puck.
There was a lot of bodies of the Islanders laying in front of the net. And because of that, TVR's going off. They kabonged a couple of guys. The referees didn't let him away with it. Here's the work down low, low to high. Too much time for Green walking the line. There's the shot. Look at Jensen as a guy. TVR hauls down Parisi. And because of that, the Caps go to the first penalty kill.
And this Islanders bunch, hot as a pistol lately on the power play at home.
Yeah, they've scored in 5 straight games overall at over 31%. Beware the Islanders. They have a power play goal in 8 straight, Joe, as you mentioned, on home ice.
First time they've done that since 96. Power play numbers, bottom of the screen. Dobson and Wahlstrom working up top. The carom to the waiting Ferravari. He'll clear for the Capitals. Noah Dobson, ready to go. Islanders' first-round pick in the summer of 2018. Dropping to Barzal. Barzal launching into this rush with Anders Lee. Lee is always a front-of-the-net guy on the power play. Dobson to the middle. Wahlstrom off the half-boards, met by Carlson. Wahlstrom working with Dobson. That's going to force the young blue liner back to neutral ice.
And the young blue liner, Dobson, really taking over a lot of the minutes of Nick Leddy, who used to be the quarterback for their power play. He's getting a lot of work, played in the American League, and now he's a full-time NHLer.
Lee finds Wahlstrom. A good stick save there for Vitek Vanacek, protecting a 1-0 advantage. Tom Wilson on the board in the first period for the visiting Capitals.
Wahlstrom leads them all in power play points. Beware of him. He can really shoot the puck.
Dobson strolling in, matched up with Ferravari and Carlson. Barzal lost it to Wilson, and Tom clears. Isles changing him up on the go. Ditto for the Caps. Brock Nelson tiptoes in there beautifully, then fan on a wrister. Follow-up, Bailey, that's denied in front. Ferravari among the Caps leaders in block shots all season long. Bailey is a very good play-by-play setup man. Long drive, Salo. Rebound was there for Bailey. Couldn't shift it to his stick in time as the Caps golf it all the way down.
Yeah, he is a guy that's been around. It's his 14th season. It's the longest tenured Islander is Bailey. Only has a couple of goals this year and doesn't score a lot when it comes to the power play.
Had a power play goal against the Devils in the last outing, his first in almost 2 years.
There you go.
Hathaway 2-on-2 the other way. Shorthanded now, coming to an end for Washington. They do the job on the PK. Capitals penalty killers against the Metro Division locker this season, 88%.
And really has not been a concern overall. That part of their special team unit has been good from day one.
Pelech bombs one in from center. We near the 8-minute mark of the second. Hard hitting continues. Jensen came up looking for a call. None from the referees today. Chris Lee and Furman South. Green waits, 39-year-old Michigan native. Snaps that pass ahead. Pelech working back into the Islander zone as they get things coordinated. Andy Green, former Devil captain. Matt Martin was dealing with Schultz. Washington propels it back into the offensive zone. Sprong with the speed, cut off by Green. This one winds up out of play. 7:53 gone by in period two, and it's Washington on the lead by one.
We have to be able to
tomorrow, Capital One. Proof of vaccination for guests age 12 and older will be required to attend all the home games starting tomorrow. The Cavs entertaining the Canucks. For more information, go to monumentalsports.com/health safety. Download the Clear app to ensure quick and easy verification for when you arrive tomorrow. To see Tom Wilson's boys entertain the Vancouver Canucks. The Canucks are busy right now on the wrong end of a score in Raleigh against Carolina's Hurricanes.
4-1, Carolina leads about 5 minutes into the third period.
Martin barreling in against Schultz. Schultz forced him to the corner. Clutterbuck's wrister is wide of the goal as we near the midway mark of regulation in this one. Washington with 20 wins and 49 points. The Isles 11 victories, 28 points. In the basement of the Metro are the Isles when play began today. Sprong had that one blocked. Long drive, Carlson goes wide of Varlama. Sprong, snap pass down low. He had Eller just failing to connect there.
He had to sauce that puck a little bit and put a little starch on it, and it went right off the stick of Eller and wide of the net.
Cizikas, who always has success against Washington, puts it into the corner. Ferravari taps for Sprong as the Capitals will make a break for it. It's Carlson through center. Ovechkin tape to tape with Backstrom offside on the entry.
Caps are doing a good job holding their blue line against the attack of the New York Islanders. That last opportunity here, the Caps stationary, just protecting the house in front, and there's the pass across. Sprong to Eller. Just doesn't connect. He has to put it over a stick, and because of that, didn't lie flat when it hit the far post, and there they are talking about it on the bench. Just missed.
Daniel now in his fifth full season as a pro. His first ever NHL assist came against the Isles. Washington's first steps today inside of UBS Arena. UBS Arena at Belmont Park in Elmont, New York, if you get it all straightened out.
It looks beautiful, doesn't it?
Sure does.
Inside and out.
Pageau hits the brakes. Parisi's next. Lockers mentioned the Isles were allergic to this barn the first seven games. They lost here.
Yeah, they had a real tough go at it, but this is going to be their playoffs on the line here. I mean, 16 of 18 overall. Just a couple of road trips upcoming for these guys.
At center, cranked in by Pelech. John Carlson waiting, Caps ice time leader. Kuznetsov then for Backstrom. Tried the drop pass there, but Bailey was in his pocket. Green for New York. Move it along through center. Lee on the drop to Barzell. On the cutback move, here comes Bailey firing. He missed it on the short side. Point position, Sallow. They'll rotate. Send down low for Lee in a stalemate with Jensen. Green comes this way for Sallow. Ovechkin was in that shooting lane. Barzell hits the brakes. Crafty center iceman. Deals it to the interior. That gets away, and it'll float back into the Islander zone.
Very, very good man-on-man defense, in particular TVR versus Barzell. Barzell is unbelievable one-on-one. He can hook off, he can curl, he stops and start. That last sequence tells you how to play one-on-one. TVR right with Barzell, no time and space, a stick length away as he tried to maneuver the puck towards the net.
So far, so good for Washington. More than halfway home in regulation in the game we expected as Irwin lets it fly. A low-scoring affair between Washington and New York. An Islander team that still loves to suffocate you in the neutral ice. Schultz sweep it down for Protas. Protas has the only helper today on the Wilson goal, his 10th back in the opening period. Irwin's pass deflected. Away comes New York. Barzal with speed trying to jump to the interior. Well defended by Irwin.
That was awesome. That's old school defense by Matt Irwin. Nicely done.
Matt bounces back up and he'll drive it in. Backstrom along the wall with Chara. Protas serves it cross rink. Snapshot on the way. Good pad save Varlamov against Ferravari.
Sweet pass by Protas. Nice offensive thrust hooking off and finding the late guy.
Carlson sweep it to the interior. Shoveled wide by Ferravari. Dobson using the boards. Failed to get it out on his first try. Backstrom seeing Nelson make a break for it the other way. Three on three. Kiefer Bellows to the corner. Marked by Carlson. Help comes from Connor McMichael, and he'll gallop back through center. On the wing for Eller. Eller's return pass never arrives. Chara to the loose biscuit with Sprong. Eller there in the shallows, along with Beauvillier. Dobson bumped him down. This is Chara trying the other flank. High on the window and past Jensen into Washington territory for an icing.
What do you want from your sports book? The best odds? Same game parlays you can boost for even more? You want to live your bet life. New customers get risk-free bets up to $2,000.
Both of these teams will play a lot of matinees this season. Washington enjoying this one so far to the tune of a 1-0 advantage. With 7:31 to go, it's the NHL on NBC Sports Washington. Van Riemsdyk fires, punched away by Varlamov.
Excellent draw win there by Kuznetsov, as clean as day against one of their better center icemen there. And they had a good chance on that play, chipping that puck back.
That's Craig Lachlan. I'm Joe Beninati. Shout out of thanks to all the men and women on the tech level today. We come to you from our D.C. studios. Dobson goes round and round for New York in the blue. Ovechkin finds Schultz. There's Ovechkin to fire, and Varlamov makes the stop on the squeeze.
And that's all because of an icing call against the Islanders that keeps the Caps on the attack after winning the draw.
Let's pay some bills. We'll get you back on the other side.
At Chipotle.
Inside of UBS Arena, a 1-0 score on the Toyota League leaderboard locker. These boys make their mark in many places.
Yeah, plain and simple, they score everywhere. Alex Ovechkin, most arenas scored in among active players, tied with Evgeny Malkin, Patrick Kane two behind, and along with Sidney Crosby. Our league leaders brought to you by Toyota today.
Ovechkin coming in, tied for second in goals in the NHL this season with Toronto's Austin Matthews. Both of those guys looking up at Leon Draisaitl. Schultz towards the cage and wide. Varlamov was heavily screened there by Protas.
Protas has had a real good hockey game today against the Islanders. He's utilized his size. He's made two very good passes. One led to the Caps' only goal by Tom Wilson. It's been very apparent, getting lots of ice time now with the Caps playing with 11 forwards.
TJ Oshie missing, played only two shifts today. About a minute and 46 seconds before he left. Same day, the Caps were notified that Connor Sherry is on the COVID protocol list. So round and round they continue. The carousel that's the Capitals roster and lineup these days. Van Riemsdyk away from Clutterbuck. Wilson has the lone goal. Shots on goal story, again, still waited for Washington as Backstrom ran into Pellick. Protas touched it down low. Wilson turns a corner. Drew a double team. It's Pellick off the glass. Schultz kept it for just a moment. Then Martin shoved him back to center. Six and change to go in period two. Deliberately, this is Pellick through center. He'll clear in. Jensen swats at it. Loose puck along the boards. Belongs to Barzal. Penalty call coming up.
Yeah, I think it's going to go against Lee for the high elbow or high stick to Tom Wilson. Their captain, I think, might be going off here.
We'll tell you who's guilty in just a few moments on NBC Sports Washington. One nothing Washington. I know the Caps road crew is in attendance today. We have this PenFed trivia question for you. Speaking of the other home, Barclays Arena, that is, in Brooklyn. Who scored the Caps' first goal there in January of 2016?
I have two names.
I also have two names.
You do?
So it's the 15-16 season. That's a President's Trophy winning squad for the Capitals. They were mighty good during the regular season that year.
The one I have is playing in today's game, and another one played for both the Islanders and the Caps.
I have nobody playing in today's game.
Okay.
Power play for Washington. Anders Lee was on his way to the sin bin when last we were talking to you prior to the break. So Caps have their second man advantage. Backstrom closing in on the toe drag move. Mayfield with that long reach pressures him to the boards.
Yeah, because Backy was looking for the backhand far post. He had created a two-on-one on the zone entry.
Carlson had that one explode off of his stick. Cizikas there to PK for New York. At point position, it's Backstrom. 1:15 left in the minor. One time, blast from Carlson, fought off by Varlamov.
And hit the stick of Cizikas, which broke it in half, and that's why Casey doesn't have his twig, and that's why it caused a little bit of a problem for the goaltender to pick up that bouncing puck.
Locker, we mentioned that Connor Sherry was added to the COVID protocol list for Washington today. We can report the same, we have been told, for assistant coach Blaine Forsythe. He is in COVID protocol. The Islanders missing their head coach, the former Washington bench boss, Barry Trotz, in COVID-19 protocol.
Lane Lambert got him a win the other night against New Jersey. It goes on Barry Trotz's one-loss record.
That's 888 for Coach Barry. 30 seconds left on the power play for Washington. Protas advancing with Sprong. Chara takes the boards away. Nelson the other way. Nelson trying to get to the inside, well defended by Schultz.
That's a veteran move by Schultz. He knew he was trying to go outside, inside, made sure his skates were aligned perfectly to take away that chance.
Protas sends it hard around. It gets past Varlamov on the horseshoe into the corner. Less than 4 minutes to go in the second. Isles 2-for-2 on the PK. Sprong waiting. Eller fires. Pad save Varlamov.
Both guys wanted to get that puck for the shot.
Anders Lee right out of the box, right into the defensive picture, has the puck for New York. The Islander captain off the boards and out. Anders Lee, who played collegiately at Notre Dame. Caps will send it in. Chara's there with a gloved hand against Leeson and Sprong.
It's a good story for Lee, and the Islanders missed so much of hockey because of his ACL surgery and recovering. It looks like he hasn't missed a beat coming back for the Islanders this season.
He has points in five of his last six games. He's tied for the goal-scoring lead. Leeson to the front door, just misfiring there. Irwin sends it down low. 3 minutes separating us from Integrate Intermission Live. Van Riemsdyk on a slap pass for Dowd. Dowd tries to get him involved again. Isles wanting a call.
I think they're going to get it, too, for tripping down Dobson, and the Caps will go to the penalty-killing unit. Sure looks like that behind the net.
Leeson with a question or two of the official.
Yep, watch Leeson lean in with his stick right there on Dobson. It looked like he lost an edge, but that stick on the left leg, not even the skate. The Schultz D one-on-one against penalty killer, the captain Lee, a nice little player. Brock Nelson, excuse me, nice little play. And here's a good clear right there to take a hit by Wilson. Is Clutterbuck on the penalty kill to make the play. And down low, Tom Wilson. Nice opportunity rotating with Carlson. Wilson down low in front of the net. No change left in front of the goaltender, Varlamov.
Pageau is the Islanders' best at the faceoff dot. He wins around 57% this season. Lars Eller being excused from the dot by Libor Stuchanek. Second power play for New York, tail end of period two. Wilson digging in, tying up Pageau's stick. Van Riemsdyk didn't get it out. Wallstrom sets. New York 5-on-4 in the blue sweaters. Pressure far from the cage coming from Lars Eller. Ditto from Jensen. Dobson will switch the point of attack. Barzell to the half boards. Pageau lets it fly. It was blocked. Wahlstrom follow-up. Pad saved by Vanacek.
Best of the game right there with the right pad by Vanacek. Big juicy rebound. They broke down the Caps penalty-killing unit and had their best looks, arguably, offensively, here in the second period.
We'll turn things over to Alexa Landeskog and LMA pretty soon for Integrate Intermission Live. Washington, a man down, another 118. Lee on the interchange, going there to the corner. It's Barzell. Like a freight train, Farivari was close by, and now Dowd storms out 2-on-2. Dowd waiting. Working against Pageau. Banked that one off the skirt of the goal. And Varlamov, who is hugging the post. Through center, Pageau in a foot race. Farivari stapled him to the boards. Hathaway clears for Washington.
That's a nice defensive play by Farivari. Pageau had some good legs under him, and he's coming up the ice at full speed. And Farivari just utilized his size, his skating, and his pivot ability to take him out cleanly.
Bailey. Back at point position, Dobson. 33 seconds left on the man advantage. Dobson looking this way. Barzell feed it inside. Nelson's drive. Vanacek was waiting. Barzell, backdoor look. One more to the front for Parisi. And Vanacek sniffs that out and covers.
I think Zach would like a do-over because he should have shot that puck. Instead, he hesitated, and then he tried to pass it across to the open man. He should have just shot the puck with Lee hanging out in front of the net. Here's the play down low. They find the bumper guy. Good pad save. The follow-up even better by Wahlstrom off the right pad. But that last opportunity might have been their best. Wahlstrom, Nelson, all in that bumper position. There's the pass to Bailey, who should have put that puck into the net. Thought it was Parisi there. He should have had a takeover and a do-over because he would have been well-served to shoot that puck.
Bailey had eyes for Parisi, but it didn't work out for New York. 12 seconds left in the shorthanded situation. A buck 12 in the period. Vitek Vanacek in his career against New York, 3-1. Save percentage now above 940 against the Isles.
A real low-event game, you'd have to say, here this afternoon. Both teams not giving it up an inch defensively. And I think the Caps between the two clubs have been stellar in their own zone so far.
Capitals will welcome Vancouver tomorrow to Capital One Arena. The Isles are scheduled to host Philadelphia on Monday.
And play Tuesday against the Flyers in back-to-back games.
Mayfield swooping out of his own zone as we're in the McNugget minute of period two. Vanacek giving the marching orders for Carlson. Farivari keeping tabs on Beauvillier as Washington clears it all the way down. This turns out to be icing.
There's a look at Parisi back here in the island. The island. He's a guy that's bounced around a little bit, got bought out in Minnesota, Joe, for big dollars, and they're going to have to still pay part of his deal for the next four or five seasons.
It all began for Zach in the New York, New Jersey area, right? 8 years with the Devils,
correct.
9 with Minnesota, now his first on the island. 45 seconds left for Washington and New York in the second period. Up close and personal with Carlson in the corner. Making a break for it, Lars Eller storming out with Leeson 2-on-2. Eller, one hand on his stick, turns to his forehand. Did not connect. Wilson sends it on around. Lars tracking it along the boards with Barzell. 23 seconds in the period. John Carlson feeds Farivari from skate to stick. Had that shot blocked. Farivari lassoed in the corner. Mayfield rolls it ahead. Barzell against Carlson 1-on-1. Barzell looking for the late guy, and it's a blast from Bailey that was blocked. Wilson was in good shape defensively, though without his stick, as the horn sounds, ending 40 minutes.
Not a lot of offense either way. Both goaltenders solid between the pipes. The star players being checked very aggressively, and some good defensive plays. The best one late in the period there by Tom Wilson. That was a tremendous block shot.
Ilya Samsonov there, 30 in the white, congratulating his mates for their defensive work through two periods, keeping New York off the board. We're getting set for Integrate Intermission Live. Coaches talking things over behind the bench. Players on the ice doing the same. After 40, it's Washington by one. Integrate Intermission Live. Here now, Alexa Landeskog and Alan May.
Integrate Intermission Live.
A scoreless second period, and we remain 1-0. The Capitals with the lead on the island. That's Alan May. I'm Alexa Landestoy. This is Capitals Integrate Intermission Live. Some chances for the Capitals in the second, but some great saves by the goaltenders.
Yeah, Vitek Vanacek on that last power play against the Islanders was excellent. He kept this team in the game. The Capitals, for the most part, that period, did a pretty good job of defensive hockey. A couple mismanagements with the puck. But overall, they're keeping the Islanders away from the net at 5-on-5.
Yeah, they're doing a good job at that. And Alexi Protas had the assist on Tom Wilson's goal in the first, and he is standing by joining us now from New York. And Alexi, you're working with Backstrom and Wilson today. What's it been like paired up with those two?
You know, it's pretty experienced guys. So excited to play with them really fast. So many great plays. So I'm so happy to play with them. Try to help them how I can, the best I can.
And the New York Islanders are a very defensive team. What is key for you guys going out in the third period to get a victory in this one?
I heard you say the puck management should be better, and I think we got to be strong defensively, play our game, play our structure, and we'll get our chances offensively, and we got to just execute out there.
Alexi, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Love hearing that. He was listening to you there. Maybe some puck management, a few more things that the Capitals can do to hold on to this lead here in the third.
I should have given him a little power play advice for the guys on that one. You know what? It's an excellent young player. And one of the things when you're watching Protas out there, and you get to watch the games with me, Alexa, is that I rant and rave about his stick work, poke checking pucks, keeping plays alive, defensively getting his puck on the stick. And players like that, he's such a heady hockey player. When we say a player has hockey sense, what it means is he understands how to play positionally, how to play with the puck, without the puck, and puck management, I think, is one of the strong points for that young player.
Yeah, Protas has been a great addition to this Capitals team this season. Well, coming up next, we're going to take a closer look at some of those Capitals chances in the second. Capitals out shooting the Isles during that second period, 10-8, still winning at the faceoff dot, but then they got another power play opportunity, Alan, and you gave me this one. Not even a single shot on that extra man unit.
No, not for the Capitals. You know, they had trouble getting into the zone on the next one, and I think the big thing there, too, on the last one, don't get any more penalties. I thought the Islanders moved the puck around very well. Vanacek keeps him in the game, and so does Nick Jensen with a big save.
Yeah, we'll take a look at some of those Isles opportunities late in this one, but first in our Geico highlights, let's take a look at some of the Capitals' chances early in here.
Yeah, there we go.
It was to Connor McMichael. I'm acting like I'm in New York right now. Clearly not. But Connor McMichael with an opportunity on Farley.
Yeah, please don't be. And great shot. You know what? Aim it off the pad. You know, you're not going to get a very good angle there. Shoot off the pad. You got Ovi driving to the net. A little while later, quick out to the front and just can't finish it off. But a great little relay in the trapezoid. Great place to create offense is back from behind the net. For the Capitals, what I've liked all game is sticks on the ice, taking away pucks. They forced the Islanders to have a lot of giveaways. Ovi with a great shot there. No traffic in front, but you love to see him getting his chances, getting his shots, and warming up.
Yeah, Varley looking strong in net right now for the Isles, and here they are on the power play opportunity. The Islanders, you were talking about, it's so dangerous, creating opportunities and testing Vanacek.
Yeah. First on Pageot and then on Wahlstrom, and what a great save by Nick Jensen on that second one. So Pageot in the middle, doesn't have a lot of success against the Capitals. And then that one hits Jensen. You got to be brave. And that was incredibly brave by Jensen to get in front of that shot.
Yeah, I'm sure we're going to have plenty to talk about post-game with Brent
Capitals.
Johnson. But he was mentioning he needed more from the goaltenders coming up with big saves when they needed them. Clearly, we got that from Vanacek. We touched on it earlier, the Capitals in the third. What do they need to do to hang on quickly?
You know what? Don't go back into a defensive posture. Continue to get after the puck and create offense.
Capitals get the win in the third period. Hopefully, we'll get your mags to Joe Beninati and Craig Laughlin just after this.
Of UBS Arena. Caps have a 1-0 lead over the Islanders in their first visit to the Isles' new playpen. Folks, coming up a little later this month, January 26th, that's a Wednesday, Capitals are honoring members of the law enforcement community. Discounted tickets are available, starting at $49. Each ticket purchased through the promotion comes with a limited edition commemorative challenge coin. A portion of the proceeds benefiting the National Law Enforcement Officers Memorial Fund. Scan the QR code on your screen or visit caps.com/specialgroups for more information. Integrate Intermission Live continues. Joe and Craig with you from our DC studios. We know Vitek Vanacek has played very well through two periods. How would you evaluate Washington's D?
A overall because they've been very good in all three zones, Joe. I think when you look at the Islanders, they're an opportunistic type team. The Caps have shut them down because they've been tight units in all three, moving up the ice and back towards their net. And one-on-ones is critical against the Islanders. They got some fancy guys that love to beat guys one-on-one, and they've stoned them. They've taken that away from the Islanders' arsenal of offense. Because of that, they go into the third up by one.
Did you notice that? It was a thumbs-up A from Arthur Fonzarelli over here as we get to the BMW Ultimate moment. It involves a cap netminding today.
Yeah, I like VTech. I said in the start of the show he needs 915 or better. It's better right now. He comes into this game at 907, stopping 90.7% of the shots. And here in this game, with and without his stick, he's been on point. They've had some high danger opportunity. That one from Wahlstrom, a real good stop. PJ Pageau gets an opportunity in front. Wahlstrom may be the best on the power play. They were moving it around to the bumper guy, and he seemed to have his game. No holes in his game. He's very tight in all his movements in the crease.
Nice job, Fonzie. That's brought to you by your Washington, D.C. BMW Centers. BMW, the ultimate driving machine. Get you back for that colorful third period in just a few moments.
Get cracking and feel unbeatable.
Saving you money on car insurance has been in Geico's playbook for 85 years. Visit geico.com today to see all the ways you can save. By Mercedes-Benz of Arlington and by Integrate. One team, one vision. Capitals have had a high volume of shots today inside of UBS Arena where they are being entertained by the Isles, leading by one after two. Before we start the third period, we need to close the book on this PenFed trivia question. It concerned another home of the Isles, Barclays Arena in Brooklyn. Who scored the Caps' first goal there, January 2016?
I'm going with Backstrom, who's playing today, or the Ice Cheetah, or Jim Dog.
Oh, geez. Did you get it right?
I don't
Jim
know.
Jim Dog? Look at this. We've got video to prove it.
I like that he's on the ice.
I was going with 90. Oh, no.
Yes.
No.
Jim Dog, short side.
No, that's total BS.
No, it isn't.
Oh, my goodness.
The Ice Cheetah.
I had Nate Schmidt and Marcus Johansson. Marcus was in the picture. Brutal, Tom. Tom Wilson, listen to me. That was brutal. Lane, you know he got help on that.
No. Nope.
You know for a fact.
I also do know he played his 1,000th game with the Islanders. Remember?
Bogus.
Yeah.
Totally bogus. Washington has the 1-0 advantage. Wilson today from Protas. 4:35 of the first.
I thought it was Backy, but I like the fact that the Ice Cheetah was on the ice.
Just randomly pulls the cheetah out. Nicely done. Albeit thoroughly cheating.
It's who you know.
No, yeah, no kidding. No kidding. VTech Vanacek giving words of instruction for Jensen, who's pounded against the boards. This low-scoring hockey game today, the Caps lost the services of TJ Oshie about 3 minutes into the game. He played only two shifts. Connor Sherry placed on COVID-19 protocol.
Down
a
coach, too.
Coach Blaine Forsythe also on that list. Washington holding firm against the Isles, leading by just one. A game where they've really had a lot of shots on goal. The advantage in terms of shots taken, the volume is definitely in Washington's favor. But where it matters most, it's just a one-point game.
And it's defense-first mentality. Anytime a team goes through a four-game skid, allowing 18 goals, you go back to the basics.
Wahlstrom tiptoes in. Great pad stop by Vanacek.
Best of the game there. I didn't like the defense of the Caps. They were too much sag in their game. No one took away Wahlstrom, who had a head of steam coming through the neutral zone. A quick rewind. It's 1-on-3, 2-on-3, and then it was a 3-on-3 to finish it. The Caps got turned around on that play. Ferravari got caught going outside. That allowed Wahlstrom to waltz inside. What a save with that left toe. From overhead, you see the traffic in front and the tremendous stop.
Quickness and flexibility on display there from VTech Vanacek as Mayfield loads up and fires to the screen. VTech had to flash those pads out again like pinball flippers to keep the puck away from the bottom of the goal. 90 seconds clear in this third period. Leeson sees it come back through center. Hathaway hog-tied by Mayfield. Mayfield, who played collegiately at Denver, sends it on through. Vanacek will allow Schultz to play from the trapezoid. stoked along the boards and back through center. Dowd maneuvering wide. Nick Dowd put it off of Varlamov. Barzell overruns it for New York as the Isles place the puck back out at center.
The Caps have kept the speed of Barzell under control here this afternoon, not allowing him to get ahead of steam in any of the zones, and because of that, he's been a non-factor. So far, so good.
Van Riemsdyk offers it ahead. McMichael at the line cross rink. Stepping in for a wrister to the front there, looking for the tip-in try with Sprong. Blocked off by Varlamov on the initial shot from Eller. Jensen snaking into the zone. As the puck is chopped away from him, Lars gathers. Eller with points, 8 points in his last 10. McMichael on the snapshot, rejected by Green. Andy Green on the hop for New York, using the boards to get it out. He put it out of play in the process.
And the veteran makes it look so easy. Green on the blue line. Matt Martin up front trying to energize the fans. Barzell, the win of the draw, working it from the point. Hard slap shot. And there's a whole lot of traffic there. And there's a left toe. Called it like a pinball flipper. Definitely at the last second he kicked it out. That last jam-in attempt on Varlamov after a good block by Green in front of Varlamov.
Washington gets Vancouver tomorrow. The Canucks beaten earlier today in Raleigh, North Carolina by the Hurricanes. Boston continues to go along nicely. They down Nashville in overtime. Taylor Hall with a winner.
That's a big win for them. The split of the top trio and moving Taylor Hall down has really helped them. I mean, they've got more balance in their attack.
Vancouver has come east under new head coach Bruce Boudreau and dropped three straight. Gabby will be welcomed to Capital One tomorrow afternoon.
They didn't make it easy. Tampa Bay, Florida, oof, Carolina, oof, Caps, and finish it off in Nashville. Thank you very much.
Wow. Strength of schedule.
Yeah.
See Gabster mulling about that. Farivari for Backstrom. Back to point position, Hathaway. All on the perimeter here. Nice passing. Fired wide by Farivari. He looked skyward. He had an open corner there. 3.5 clear in the third. Isles send it all the way. This is icing against New York.
Marty's had another good game looking for his fourth goal. Real good passing sequence by the Capitals. The Islanders mostly sag and get back to coverage and home plate. Good redirect there by Martin, taking that slap shot off the end of his stick. But the Capitals pushing the pace, trying to get that next goal here. And that was a real good look by Farivari.
Farivari tied for the rookie lead in plus minus. Kuznetsov's drive is answered by Varlamov. Farivari tied in that rookie plus minus lead with Florida's Anton Lundell. Wahlstrom clears it in. Vanacek's going to melt it.
So you should get the PenFed Power Cash Rewards card.
I hear it's got no annual fee.
PenFed lets me earn on all my jumps.
Earn up to 2% cash back on purchases, whether you're in uniform or not. PenFed's got great rates
for everyone. This is a yes-no question.
Okay.
Would you ever try skydiving?
Yes. If you came up with me in the plane and you went first.
That's a hard no. Absolutely.
Why?
Hard no.
I'll be positive with you. I'll push you out. And I'll see what happens and then I'll go.
Farewell. Oh, no way. Not out of a perfectly good plane. No way. Icing against
Washington.
Come on,
buddy. That's what we could plan this summer. It would be a great thing. We could
summer
put
thing?
On Instagram.
Yeah.
It would be very cool.
Listen to me. No.
Locker pushes Joe out of an airplane.
Oh, boy. You talk about the angry elf on a shelf. There would be some angst involved in that quickly. A little bit more than 4 minutes old are we in the third. Shots on goal attempted, at least, at the top and bottom of your screen. Joe and Craig with you from our D.C. studios. Long wrister as the Caps are at UBS Arena at Belmont Park in Elmont, New York. The Islanders will get a lot of home cooking in the next few weeks. Varlamov sends it on around. Tom Wilson has the lone goal today. It happened at this end of the rink in the first period. Garnet Hathaway lets it come through. Around she rolls, corner boards. Dowd covering up at the point. Schultz sends it on the way, knocked down in front. Washington and New York. The Caps took 6 of 8 from the Isles a season ago when they were Mass Mutual East Division mates. Schultz had a game winner late in regulation in one of those for Washington. Bailey working on out. Barzell, then Dobson cruising in. Pad save for Vanacek.
Absolutely nothing going for the Islanders. That was a sharp angle shot, made it look easy, was the Capitals netminder Vitek, and good play defensively. Everything outside the dots, they're not getting inside, especially five on five.
Wilson slugged that one right on. Varlamov made the save. As we near the 6 minute mark of the third, J.G. Pageau had this deflected by Wilson into the New York bench. Folks, Burke and Herbert Bank are once again donating $100 for every Caps goal scored to a deserving local nonprofit organization. That's Grand Inval from Fairfax, Virginia this season, a organization that places volunteers in local Title I elementary schools. They've done tremendous work. Volunteers a huge help with all the virtual learning that's going on. As the kids are getting back to school, Cizikas has the draw for New York, but Wilson stole it. Jensen for Tom Wilson from the severe angle. Kuznetsov sweeps it on around. Mayfield to intercept and play it on through. Jensen gets back into position for Washington. Capitals aiming to stop a four-game winless skid, their longest of the season. Wilson on the drop for the captain, Ovechkin. Ovechkin mugged up with Cizikas. Kuznetsov hurls one at the cage. It's high. Van Riemsdyk send it down low again. Cizikas there to support defensively. And this is looped back out to neutral ice. Schultz on the rewind. That pass from Wilson was forced to the middle. Salo will swing. Robin Salo getting the jersey today. Sebastian Aho, another of the Islanders' new papas, sitting this one out as a healthy scratch. On the fly, three on three. Bellows lets it go. Around the wall it comes. Beauvillier. Pinched to the boards by Schultz.
This is an offensive player's nightmare type of game. You just aren't getting opportunities. Look at how everyone's just cloaking one another five on five. It's crazy. You can't get open.
Salo fires. That one drifted wide again. Vanacek lost the handle on his goalie stick. Second time today that's happened. Islanders at point position. Salo from Pelech. Rotate it down low. Vitek has his goalie stick. Bellows slugged that one wide. High slot, Beauvillier with a rocket knockdown. Follow-up chance, chopped wide. Pellet was cruising in down the slot area. Islanders with their most persistent shift of the night and day, that is.
Absolutely, they got some good pressure because their D got some pucks through, and then they're looking for chaos in front of Vitek. And they had some. Bellows again all around the net this afternoon for the Islanders offensively.
Nicklas Backstrom will scoop it in. Varlamov's gonna take no chances now with 12:27 to go in regulation. Caps and Isles, first of four. A low-scoring game led by DC. You can join us January 24th. It's Caps Canines Night. Pawsented, isn't that cute? Pawsented by the Pedigree Foundation. Tickets start at just $49. All purchases made through the special link. Receiving a Caps Canines t-shirt and dog bandana. Scan the QR code or visit washcaps.com/special groups.
Sounds like a great night against Vegas and the Golden Knights, who are rocking and rolling out west.
Pretty good team.
Yes, they are.
Farivari for Washington on the lead by one, thanks to Tom Wilson way back in the opening period. That's the only goal on the score sheet until this effort from Daniel Sprong. Sprong gets the relay back from Farivari. Five on five action, 8 minutes down in the third period. Two teams that won't see each other again till the middle of March, originally scheduled, but there may be a makeup in order. The league, I'm sure, is working on rescheduling during the Olympic break.
Yeah, they have 100 or more games to reschedule throughout the National Hockey League.
Expect to be learning about those dates pretty soon as John Carlson sends it in. Along the backboards, Dano Chara rumbling with it. Off the wall and out. Dowd doubled up along the dasher. McMichael there, and the youngster put it out of play.
Again, stick on puck, no room to operate. Absolutely no speed between the two blue lines, between these two hockey clubs. And that's a staple for defense. If you slow down teams between the two blues, it's hard to generate offense. The Capitals have taken care of Lee. They've taken care of the centermen up the middle. Barzal in particular, Pageau, Cizikas. They have not had the puck a lot in the good ice. That's a good sign.
One of the few times, Locker, this season where the Caps have been stalled offensively, including today.
For sure.
Just 13 goals in the last six games, including today, for the guys in the Capitals sweaters. Islanders trying to tie this one up. Barzal circles the cage. Barzal waits. Point position on around to Green. Green waits with patience on the outside. Loads and fires. Had it blocked in front by Hathaway as the Capitals will clear. We're nearing the midway mark of the third. Barzal hoping to ignite the offense on this rush. Barzal drops it to Bailey. Sallow long range. Deflected down in front of Vanacek. Capitals again doing the job defensively to chase New York into its own zone.
Getting in shooting lanes, not only the forwards, the D doing a great job. That was TVR blocking that shot in front of the net.
Wahlstrom waltzing in. There's a penalty call coming up.
Yeah, I think it's going against the Caps on the back check. It's going to be a hook. There's a perfect example of what speed does when you get through the neutral zone in a hurry. Forces the defense to backpedal, backtrack, and now get a piece of you, and that's why Schultz is in the box. Wahlstrom's had a good hockey game. There's the reach in, not once, but twice. Once from the back checker, once from Schultz. Wahlstrom draws a penalty, and the Caps go to the PK.
Islanders on home ice are 22% effective with a man advantage. Very critical juncture of this game right now. Tight-knit. Low scoring, nail-biting 1-0 lead for Washington as Peter Laviolette mulls it over from behind the bench.
Washington penalty number two.
Power play number three for the New Yorkers in blue.
And thank goodness that was a misplay at the blue line by the forward and Dobson. You got it. No, you got it. And then no one had it, and it came out over the blue line. That's a good thing for the Capitals penalty kill.
Eller and Wilson starting as the PK forwards. Jensen and Van Riemsdyk in back. Nick golfing at it. He ran Dobson to the ditch. Van Riemsdyk looking after Lee. Around she comes, and Van Riemsdyk clears. With 9:55 to go. Noah Dobson, 22-year-old from Prince Edward Island, Atlantic Maritime Canadian province. Pageau keeping it on the lip of the boards. JG for Dobson. Once more to Barzal. They have it set. Waiting in the weeds there, it's Wahlstrom, who is jammed by the pass. Snapshot on the way goes wide. Sprinting to the loose biscuit, Ferravari. Turned back by Barzal. 55 seconds left shorthanded. Dobson thinks about it. Barzal slowing the tempo. Seam pass looking to Wahlstrom. He's able to keep it in. Hathaway looking after him. Dobson lets it fly down low, looking for the tip of Pageau, and it's slugged out of there by Carlson.
Four righties and a lefty on the power play for the Islanders, and only one guy teeing up a one-timer on the far side in Alex Ovechkin's office. They couldn't get it to him, but it looks like that's their plan, is to get it over to the one-timer player.
Parisi drops it into the corner. Beauvillier and Nelson racing after it. Wilson has it for Washington, and it's an easy clear for Tom. 10 seconds left shorthanded. 8.5 to go in the third period. End to end comes Sallow. Jensen put a lift check on him. Sallow stays strong on the puck. Hathaway likewise, and Garnett clears.
It's all about winning battles when you're finishing off a PK, and that's exactly what the Caps did against the Isles.
Parisi turning and burning down the wing. Irwin takes care of him. Back to 5-on-5 as Ovechkin rumbles after it. Beauvillier lost it to the Capital captain. Ferravari calming things down. Sends it for Brett Leason on the dump in. Mayfield cut off Leason. That allows Clutterbuck to get to the loose biscuit and clear. With 7:55 to go in the third. Fast moving in this third period.
Fast moving, and next goal wins. That's what this game's going to come down to.
hate it when you say that.
I know you do.
That's really, why I said truly that. Hate it when you say that.
That's why I say it.
You do it just to irritate me. I know why.
It's finally sunk in, hasn't it?
25 years worth of sinking in. 7.5 to go. McMichael flushing out Dobson. Noah leaves him in the dust, plays it out there on the wing. Sturdy hit along the boards. Barzell tied up with Lars Eller. Caps have it. It's Daniel Sprong skipping through center. Sprong accelerates wide on Chara. Rolls one to the front. McMichael was there. Didn't get a blade on it cleanly. Chara coughed it up. Sprong fires wide of Varlamov. Stuff attempt. And Semyon got back there to beat McMichael. Connor almost had another backhand chance at the doorstep.
That was a game saver there with the right pad. Real nice wrap by McMichael. Very quick to get around that post.
Sprong in good shape defensively. Working back through center on the zigzag. Sprong with plenty in the tank. Fires. Shrugged away by Varlama.
He's amazing. When he makes his legs move, he's an amazing skater. And that's what he's done this whole game. When he gets the puck, he's taken 3-4 strides to get at full speed. And that makes him a difference maker.
Sprong with 4 points in his last half dozen games. Caps lost TJ Oshie early in this contest. Didn't play 2 minutes to TJ, two shifts, all that he was able to last this afternoon. Connor Sherry now on COVID-19 protocol. Leeson's backhand pass, Hathaway sent it wide. Dowd, topside, Irwin. Keep that five-man cycle humming. Green with a nice maneuver to get away from Leeson. Veteran blue liner on the verge of his 40th birthday. Sends it on back for Salo. Robin Salo, a second-round pick in the draft of 2017 for New York. Ferravari outlasting Nelson. Nelson, who missed a lot of time recently, gets pinched along the boards. He's only played, Nelson, 4 games in the last 30 days. Say that for a lot of the Islanders with the amount of time games that they had postponed.
I wouldn't have minded that schedule.
That's the locker bonus.
Yeah.
As Protas clears it in, 5:15 left in the third period. Wilson trying to center. Pellick was in the way. All-star rear guard for New York. Long drive, shrugged down by Varlamov, and he'll pounce down quickly on it. 5:05 left in regulation. Washington 1, New York nothing on NBC Sports Washington.
This is your
win of the X5.
Nice to see Tom Wilson get this puck from Brodus. Take his time. Deadly accurate over the right pad of Varlamov. And that's the only goal we've had. That came in the first period. His last goal was versus Anaheim 7 games ago. So for Tom, that's great that he's now got some confidence in his shooting.
That goal brought to you by Wilson and by Xfinity XFi, internet that's more than just fast.
And for Tom, that was his 10th. The Caps have now 4 guys in double digits in goals.
Faceoff to come, offensive end for Washington. Getting very late now in regulation in this 1-0 game. Cizikas breaks through the defense of Lars Eller, wraps one around. Alex Ovechkin just ahead of Matt Martin. Alex will clear it with enough pace to be icing against Washington.
Good back check there by Alex Ovechkin against the Islanders. They're going to throw everything they possibly can right now with 4:43 to go. Here's that last play coming up the ice, trailing from behind. Cizikas goes wide, then it's going to throw it in front of the net. Alex Ovechkin on the back check picks it off before it gets to Martin. Nice job defensively on the Cizikas line by Alex.
Casey will turn 31 at the end of February.
Signed a new 6-year deal with the Islanders.
Now 11 seasons as a pro. Always a thorn in Washington's side, Casey Cizikas.
And I always remember our one All-Star game we did together in the American League down in Atlantic City. He was one of the stars of that game.
Look what he's done. Player.
Yes.
Backhand to the front from Beauvillier that didn't get through. Back on it, Bailey to retrace his steps. Noah Dobson leaving it in the lurch for Barzell. He'll wind it up with 4 minutes left in the third. Matt Barzell plays it out wide. Gets the return pass, hooks away from Carlson. spots Noah Dobson at the point. We're 5-on-5 with 3:50 left. Hathaway turned it back for Carlson wisely. John managed to get it out. Time continues to tick. We'll keep an eye on Varlamov and see when he'll be lifted for the extra attacker. Barzell drops it over the head of Vanacek. To the corner goes Parisi with Backstrom. Nicholas protecting the biscuit and able to get it out with the help of Tom Wilson.
Smart hockey all around by the guys in white. Easy exits because they're making the correct plays.
This one pinballs towards the front. Protas, who assisted on the Wilson strike way back in the first. Wilson guarded by Green. 3 minutes to go in the third. Irwin managed to keep that alive. Wilson turns the corner. Bang, bang, play. Varlamov, a huge stop on Backstrom.
Yeah, that's a game saver right there. Kept the play alive.
J.G. Pageau throwing some snow. Gets help from Wallstrom. Centering pass off the blocker of Vanacek. Backstrom there. Turning back away from Parise. Irwin bracketed back behind the goal. Parise to the point. High slot area. Zach turns and fires. Rebounds loose at the doorstep. Vanacek made the save on Wallstrom. Just 2:29 left. Washington clinging to the advantage on Long Island.
Post game live. We're going to be breaking down this one. Also looking ahead to tomorrow's game against the Canucks. But Alan, what do the Capitals need to do to hang on here?
Well, Locker always calls it the danger zones, the blue lines at both ends. Get it out of the Capitals zone. Make smart plays by the wingers and the defensemen. Keep the puck to the boards and get it in at the offensive zone. Take away the middle of the ice. Do not let the Islanders get back into this one.
Joby and Locker, we'll send it back over to you.
Alexa, we appreciate it. Look forward to your thoughts with Alan and with Brent Johnson coming up on Caps Post Game Live, presented by your D.C. area Acura dealers. 2 minutes and 20 seconds away from the finish line in this 1-0 game. Washington's first ever visit to UBS Arena. Bellows fanned on a wrister, cleaned up by Ferravari. He'll go off the glass and out. The Islanders are begging for delay of game here.
No, I don't think so. They hit the top of the glass there, and everybody on the ice in zebra colors, zebra stripes, are saying, yes, it definitely hit the glass. Smart move by Ferravari getting it up and high because they were sealing the wall. Hit the top of the glass, and out it went. The Islanders had three guys waiting for the pass coming around. He made sure it was high and hard. Hit the glass and out. Face-off to the left of Vita.
Linesman Libor Suchanek emphatically came in and gave that signal that it was deflected off the glass. Lane Lambert, the associate head coach for the Isles, subbing in for Barry Trotz, who's on COVID-19 protocol, has lifted Varlamov. So there are six attackers out there now in blue for New York. Looking for the late equalizer. Eller with a good face-off win. Carlson around the boards. Ovechkin a long way from the cage, launching it on down. And it's icing against the Caps.
Didn't miss by much. That would have been the full length of the ice. Goal line to goal line for Ovi. Quickly getting to that right corner to fire that down into the empty net. Just missed by about 6 feet. And 2 minutes left exactly now for the Islanders and Caps this afternoon.
Ovechkin has scored 5 empty netters this season. At the bottom of the screen, you see how this is often the tune for the Caps and Islanders. New York skating 6-on-5 with the empty net. Dobson takes the pass from Barzell. Nelson at the top as well. Brock Nelson shaking loose from Ovechkin. This drive hung on there. Vanacek made the save, and he trapped it into the glove off the bid from Wallstrom.
Yeah, Wallstrom's at a shooting fancy here this afternoon. He shoots the puck from everywhere. Wallstrom has 8 goals on the season, and he's really shooting that puck. He rotated up high, sharp angle shot. He was looking probably for a rebound coming off the short side with Lee, Pageau, and company hanging out in front of the net. He didn't get it. That, to me, is a great snare by Vitek. If it comes off him, the Caps could have been in trouble.
You can see why Wallstrom leads the Islanders in shots as New York has taken the timeout. They'll gather the boys around and try and diagram a tying tally. as Scott Arneal whispers in the ear of his Capital defenders.
Yep, both teams will have a plan coming out of this timeout as it clicks on down, including Vitek Vanacek, just making sure they're all on the same page and work hard to try to get this 2 points today.
Shouting out a big hello to those who are rocking the rink at the Wharf. Outdoor viewing party with the NHL on NBC Sports Washington. A marquee matchup brought to you by Sandy Spring Bank. They believe real banking is a conversation. Let's talk. We are talking about the Caps trying to hold off New York in a 6-on-5 with a net empty. Face off to the right of Vanacek. Dowd settles in. Tied up with Pageau. Islanders get the draw. Stepping in from the angle, Barzal fires! Pad save Vanacek.
That was a beauty. He held his side and held close to the post. Didn't shift to the other side.
Settling in here for another wrister. That didn't get through. Point position, working on around. Barzal intercepting, taking away and clearing for Washington. It'll roll all the way and wide for Eisen.
No, Barzal is as shifty as they come, and it just about costs the Caps, and Laviolette looks on. A long 72 seconds await the Caps to get out of town here in the new arena on the island, UBS. Here's Barzal, a great opportunity, arguably his best chance. I think the Caps have kept him well under control in today's game.
12 seconds away from the McNugget minute with Washington protecting the one goal advantage. Isles get the draw. Dobson, send it out wide. Dobson is straight away on the boards, Barzal. Long slapper, that sizzler went wide. Wallstrom takes it off the woodwork. Carlson's right there at his hip. Dobson brings it on around. We are in the McNugget minute. Dobson settles. Nelson looking for Wallstrom. He broke his stick in half. On the corner curve. Caps don't get it clear. Dobson saucers this one to Barzal. Working downhill now off the boards. Barzal closing. Dobson fakes it around Dowd. Wallstrom feeds, snapshot on the way, shrugged away. Vanacek made that stop. Pageau with 30 seconds to go. 6-on-5 for the Isles. Dobson fires, Hathaway blocked it beautifully.
Timing's everything, perfect timing on a blocked shot by Hath.
Barzal stepping in, final 17 ticks. Dobson unloads, knocked down by Backstrom, sending away Ovechkin, sprinting to the empty cage. Alex Ovechkin seals the deal.
Love it. Alex had a couple of helpers the last four games. Now he's got his 25th goal of the season. Wonderful work, great speed up ice, and just lays it in for the win this afternoon. I said next goal wins. That's the next goal I was hoping for. And here's Wallstrom moving it around. They had a couple of good looks. That hard Nelson shot to the shoulder denied by Vitek and then laying it on the line. Look at Hathaway. You wonder why the teammates and everybody loves this guy. A block there by Nicky, all leads to this empty netter, the sixth for Alex Ovechkin.
Culmination of a terrific defensive effort from Washington and career six, shutout number three for Vitek Vanacek. It's a 2-0 Washington win.
That's a sweet win to go on the road against a team that's playing really well on home ice recently. The Capitals buckled down. Their whole game plan is determined and based on defense. Well, this was an excellent example for the guys in white to get a 2-0 win.
High fives and handshakes all around for Vitek Vanacek. Washington picks up win number 21. They take the first of their two matinees this weekend. Time for us now to cross over via WebEx by Cisco. Alan May, what was the best part of Washington's defensive effort today?
Well, I just thought that they were managing the puck so much better and not stretching out. Locker talked about it in the pregame. I talked about it a little bit. You did. And you know, where the forwards weren't sneaking out of the zone too soon. And when they play like that, when they play as a five-man unit, it's a lot easier to play defensive hockey. I said the key to the game before this game was to out-defend a defensive team. I thought the Caps did an incredible job today, and I really liked the look of Haglund, Leason, or Hathaway, Dowd and Leason today, and I thought they managed the puck very well, patrolled their positions, and did a good job of shutting down the Islanders and not let them create a lot of offense. And I just think that was the biggest thing in this one, guys, is making sure that they took care of their own end first. They suppressed shots. They blocked shots, that shot by Hathaway at the end. And I thought that was the big difference.
Yeah, and how about Vitek Vanacek coming in late with some great saves as well?
Well, absolutely. I look at Vitek today. He was ready to play, and he needed to.